The vast history of human civilization withholds many secrets that are buried beneath the earth, remnants of worlds that are long forgotten, relics that are the reflection of human development, and even secrets that share an unremitting horror, never meant for the world. At the ruins of an ancient tribe, year 1996, a team led by Professor Soya have not only uncovered what they believe may possibly be the greatest discovery of all time, but uncover a horror that was never meant for the world. At first, it was just a bizarre formation in the earth, layers stacked upon layers, which was very unnatural for a fold, like they were piled artificially. But when getting a good look, they resembled the features of a human, lying face side up. And when digging deeper into the earth, that was when Professor Soya and his crew uncovered what looked like the remains of a ritual. According to Professor Soya, it seemed like a burial ritual for an infant child, burying the child's body little by little with layers of clay, doing this gradually, creating a human-shaped tomb. And as time passed, the tomb got buried under the ground, thus making this possibly the biggest discovery for Professor Soya and his team. Today's story, my friends, begins 21 years later. A mother and her two daughters, who are on their way to attend a ceremony, celebrating the anniversary of a family member who had passed on 13 years ago, who happens to be Professor Soya. But this small family of three, my friends, has a terrible cancer. A disease from within that had slowly turned the family into a bitter, dysfunctional mockery of what it should have been. Introduction Raimi, reluctantly, the pride and joy of this family, was once an adorable child that captured the hearts of so many during her years in show business. Now, a young adult who can't bring herself to appreciate the overwhelming life that her mother had put her through. Even though Raimi smiled at the moments when her mother would talk about the adorable things she did when she was a child, like when Raimi would ask her mother to carry her, it was always a warming memory for Miss Soya. Her little Raimi always asking her mommy to be caring, but being honest with her feelings. Raimi did not enjoy the life as a TV personality, a lifestyle that deprived her from the years of growing up as a normal child, which is why she quit and hopefully pursue a normal life. Raimi's sister, however, Narumi, was not really too fond of her sister's upbringing, especially with her mother's doting behavior over Raimi, clenching with this inner spite when seeing her mother throw herself into this crying frenzy when Raimi confessed her feelings, overhearing her mom wishing that she could find some way to give back all those years that were lost to her beloved Raimi, to turn back time when she was just 2 years old and spoil her precious daughter, carry her as much as she wants. Yeah, it should be obvious why Narumi has a growing hatred for her family. Like sitting on the sidelines and watching a life that she never got. Watching her mother spend all her money and her time with her precious Raimi. Like the time when Narumi needed to get her teeth done. Instead, every dollar had went to Raimi's practice lessons or whatever else she was into. Which is why Narumi's now stuck with awful teeth. One thing that Miss Soya did not really care for was Narumi's unfair feelings and her jealousy over her sister. Of course she invests all her money on Raimi. Why not? Even after she quit show business, every dollar, every minute went to Raimi. It's because unlike Narumi, Raimi has good future prospects. Fact is, there was nothing Miss Soya could do for Narumi. It's because her daughter was just too ugly. Cruel, unforgiving words that had not only struck Narumi with shock, but distracted her concentration from the road long enough to where she had almost hit an oncoming truck before driving off the highway and crashing into a ditch. When Narumi awakened, immediately checking to see if her mother and sister were okay, there was a road sign that ended up going through Raimi's window, and noticing how Raimi wasn't responsive nor moving like her mother, it was when Narumi noticed this dangling thing that was stuck on the sign. At first, Narumi thought it was a piece of clothing, but when having a closer look at this thing, noticing the eye that was looking back at Narumi, there was an overwhelming sense of horror within Narumi when realizing that it was a piece of Raimi's face that had been ripped off after being struck by the sign. The waiting room of a local hospital was now filled with a mother's grief, Miss Soya throwing herself into a panic frenzy when knowing that Raimi's beautiful face is now ruined, and she never hesitated on venting out her warped emotions on Narumi. Narumi was always jealous of Raimi. Regardless of what becomes of her precious Raimi, Miss Soya will make sure that Narumi knows that it's all her fault. All because of Narumi and her cancerous envy that Raimi's life is now ruined. However, when Raimi regained consciousness, there was something bizarre that the doctor had to share with Miss Soya. You see, when the left side of Raimi's face was sliced off, there should have been exposed muscle tissue, but instead, her face is still somewhat there, meaning that somehow, there is another layer of skin underneath the one that was sliced off. But before the doctor could see about repairing the damages to Raimi's face, he had to know exactly what it is that he's dealing with. Because obviously, this was something new and incredibly bizarre. After having Raimi go through an MRI, what the doctor found was something that is unbelievable, impossible. According to the scan, Raimi doesn't have the same internal organs nor skeletal structure as a normal human being. What the scan is showing are what seem to be stacked layers of Raimi, meaning that this was a record of Raimi's growth that begins with the embryonic form that is centered within Raimi's body. Basically, the exposed skin is actually Raimi, except a year younger. And after the doctor gave his professional opinion, heavily advising Miss Soya to have Raimi kept for further observation so that she could be thoroughly examined and to see about having her face properly treated. However, Miss Soya was against the idea of keeping her daughter at the hospital. In fact, Miss Soya preferred taking Raimi home instead, and to make sure that Raimi's condition doesn't get disclosed. The fact is, Miss Soya just doesn't like the idea of seeing her precious daughter wasting her life away in some lab for future examinations, seen by the whole world as some freak, when knowing that she's far much more than that. That's not the attention she wants for Raimi, exposed as some medical freak, when it's obvious that she's much, much more than that. Which is why Miss Soya would rather take her chances by finding an alternative way of fixing Raimi's face and condition. Unlike her mother, Narumi knew that this was something far much more than just a medical discovery. For years, she and Raimi have known about a terrible secret that had preyed upon this family. She remembered the ruins that her father found 21 years ago, the photos he took, the baby's skull buried within the layers of earth, much similar to Raimi's MRI scan. The fact is, that tomb was a curse. And her father broke the seal and never realized the horrors he had unleashed. After the discovery, his mental state began to deteriorate, wasting his days away with his obsession over the skull and its secrets. 9 years after finding that skull, That was when Narumi's father had passed away. But the story does not end there. You see, that curse had passed on to Raimi, who was born a year after her father's great discovery. And then it passed on to Narumi. And because of her mother's obsession with Raimi's future, she had never once bothered to notice how this curse had taken its toll on her daughters. And even though her mother may not care, Narumi still showed her mother the proof of her claims when showing her mouth. Much like Raimi, Narumi has several layers of teeth. Maybe if her mother had tried to get her teeth fixed, she would have noticed this years ago. When Raimi was finally brought home, a mother's love was now becoming more unbearable for Raimi. Her coddling ways was giving Raimi an inner sense of disgust. And as Misoya desperately tried to ease Raimi with the promises of finding a way to fix her face, more like fix her condition, that was when Narumi thought of a way to help Raimi by asking the university where the skull is being kept and giving it a memorial service. But Misoya was not in the mood for Narumi and her superstitious rubbish, still blaming her daughter for all this. But even Raimi knew about this condition long before her mother did, also believing it to be a curse, that she'll never know if Narumi's idea will work or not, unless they give it a try. But seeing her mother denying her sister's idea of helping her, vowing to find the best doctor to fix her face and disease, so that everything could go back to normal, the way it was, the way it should be. That was when Raimi had enough of her mother's unbearable ways and began lashing out against her. For so many years, Raimi had withheld her true feelings with her mother in her toxic ways. The truth is, it's because of Raimi's mother and her obsession with her daughter's future that Raimi isn't truly happy. Because of her, there was no warming childhood memories, nor a life of being raised within a healthy, loving family. It was all about her mother's obsession with Raimi's future as a prosperous star, never caring that she was raising a girl who'd grown into a miserable woman that was hiding behind a fake smile for way too long. It's because of her mother that she and Narumi have had a struggling relationship, showering her precious daughter with unbearable love and gifts, while just downright neglecting Narumi and her feelings, and even having the audacity to blame Narumi for what happened to her face, when Raimi knows damn well that all of this was because of her mother. That night, my friends, there was curious thoughts that withheld deviant intentions, layers. That was what the doctor said. There are layers of Raimi within her body, younger versions of her beloved daughter. The doctor also said that whatever is happening to Raimi is a medical condition that definitely needs to be properly examined and treated. Narumi entertaining the idea of this being the results of an ancient curse. But for a mother, it's something else. That night, a lot had went through the mind of Misoya. Rather than coming to her senses, think of a way to rebuild her family and give her daughters the proper treatment. Her obsession with Raimi's future had her dwelling on a horrible idea. An idea that she just could not shake away. That maybe, just maybe, this is an opportunity to undo her mistakes. A second chance. You know, like go back in time, when her precious Raimi was just 2 years old. Reliving those moments when she was an adorable little girl. Is it possible that somewhere inside this body is her precious little daughter? And that was why Misoya spent her night within Raimi's room, not speaking to her daughter, but trying to reach out to her precious little Raimi. And as hours wasted away, and Misoya was without a sign, A mother's grief would suddenly be washed away when hearing the faint cries from Mama. It was Raimi, asleep and yet asking for her mommy, with this innocent voice, asking to be carried. Finally, it was the answer that Miss Soya had hoped for. Somewhere inside this body was her precious little girl asking to be carried, and her fingers going inside the outer flesh of Remy's face, gently grabbing the skin, peeling it very slowly as if it were strong tape, exposing the skin underneath. And as expected, it was Remy's face underneath the torn skin. When waking to the sounds of Remy's screaming in pain, immediately Narumi rushed to her room, unprepared for what she saw in Remy's room. Her mother hovering over her sister, with a knife in one hand, and the flesh of Remy's face in the other. It was like Narumi was in a nightmare. Her mother's frantic look as her sister lay there on the bed screaming in pain. Of course, Narumi wouldn't understand, but if she could just listen, Narumi can hear her. That somewhere inside this body is her precious little girl crying to be let out of this dark and narrow place. And Miss Soya knows that it hurts Raimi when she has to remove a layer of flesh, but it will all be okay. She just has to be very careful, that's all. And watching her mother peel away a layer of flesh, Narumi was now traumatized with horror. Her mother cutting and peeling several layers of Raimi's face, knowing that her sister was in pain while her mother was completely blind with the thoughts of holding her precious little girl once again. There she was, that beautiful little girl, 2 years old and so happy to see her mommy, already wanting to be carried by her mother, and wasting no time. It was when Miss Soya demanded Narumi to help her on peeling away Raimi's body, and that was when both Narumi and Miss Soya began tearing away Raimi's flesh, trying to free the little girl that was trapped inside. And when Miss Soya and Narumi had finally freed the child within Raimi's body, what they saw was not what they expected. Of course, this was Raimi at 2 years old, a little girl trapped within the body of her older selves. Is that she'd grown? Her insides must have expanded, her hands, feet, whole body stretched away from the center. And watching the child so happy to see her mother once again, asking to be carried by her mommy, that was when Miss Soya took the knife and cut into the side of her face. Obviously, Narumi wouldn't understand, but it's a great idea. Seeing how this family is inflicted by a curse, well, all she has to do is peel away enough skin and return to her 38-year-old self. And then she can give birth to Raimi again, and grabbing the flesh on her face. Yes, it's painful. If done quickly, the pain will go away. That's all it takes. And that was when Miss Soya quickly peeled away her face and screamed in sheer terror, shocked by the sudden wave of pain when realizing that she wasn't affected by the curse. Since that night, Narumi had desperately tried to undo the curse when seeking out the infant's skull, hopefully repair whatever was left of her family. Unfortunately, the skull had went missing. Till this very day, the skull was never found. As to what had became of the Soya family, even though Narumi can live out a normal life, that wasn't going to happen, seeing how her sense of helplessness grows every day. Miss Soya now lives in seclusion, never setting foot in public again. Eventually, she isolated herself in that room with her precious Raimi. And as for Raimi, in time, she began to grow layers again. However, her appearance did not resemble what she used to look like. I guess when you peel off her skin, it doesn't grow back the same way again. As of now, Raimi is a grotesque abomination that still wants to be carried by her mommy.